What's up, it's Nez, and hey friendos, and welcome back for some more Monster Prom Modtool. Today we'll be checking out Mr. Slenderman by Cami. Yes, finally a Slenderman mod, about fucking time. Who needs to wait for Montecam for some creepypasta monsters when we can have them right now? Let's go! One player, second term, short game. Ah, spooky high school, the sweetest years of our lives. Back then we were young and unafraid. Sometimes reckless, sometimes brilliant, sometimes just stupid, but always willing to live life to the fullest. We were on a wild journey to discover who we really were. Who are you? Let's play as Blue.
Sweet.
And we had yet to experience its ultimate challenge, the Monster Prom. I remember it clearly. 3 weeks were left, and as we fantasized about our dream prom dates, we were all scrambling to catch the attention of one of our 8 most charismatic classmates. Scott Howell, 21. A werewolf athlete compensated for his rather small brain with a stupidly huge heart. Miranda Vanderbilt, 19. A sweet mermaid princess who's as cute as she was genocidal. Polly Geist, 22 question mark. A party goat with insatiable hunger for all the wrong things. Damon LeVay, 21. A fearless demon with a taste for destruction and a love of fire. Liam DeLinecourt, 4XX. A hipster vampire who standoffish to meet or hit the fact that he was a truly lovable dork. Zoe Forever. An eldritch cutie who went from endless dating to Dark Realms to ultimate fangirl. Calculester Hewlett-Packard 1.0. A library computer become a sentient robot ready to experience life to its fullest. And Virobilin 23. A mean self-made gorgon with a merciless sense of business. It was clear. It had to be one of them, but who? We only had 3 weeks to choose our prom date, and even more daunting, we only had 3 weeks to woo them and conquer their heart. But as I already said, we were young and unafraid, and we were ready to start. Welcome to Monster Prom, stupidest pop quiz ever! All minds are rotten, but they are rotten in so many different ways. Worry no more, we're using our PhD in bullshit to diagnose which kind of deviant sicko you are. Monster Prom, stupidest pop quiz ever, TM, will throw a bunch of absurd questions at you and turn your answers into your character's stats. This way, each of you will start by having stats that better reflect your true selves. Let's start! You're elected president for a day, what's the first law you pass? Trivia fact, presidents don't pass laws, so is this a trick question or are you just being an idiot? What is your spirit emoji? An octopus emoji, best animal on earth. I know 5 mixed drinks, 3 drug cocktails, and 17 sex positions that involve one or several octopi. School just isn't working out. Time to go stripping. What's your stage name? Kawaii Pussy Oo. And you find your zodiac sign to be inaccurate. Design your own personal zodiac sign. The ambiguous iguana. And back to Spooky High.
Let's go!
Week 1, morning. Let's go to shopkeep, pick up the item.
Give me your money.
And here we go. The suspicious looking picture. A picture of a bunch of children playing in the schoolyard, yeah? Wait a minute, is that Mr. Slenderman? Oh, a picture of Mr. Slenderman? Interesting.
Later, Gator.
And remember the first rule of Shop Club, yeah? No refunds. Bye, shopkeep. Okay, time for lunch.
Let's go!
So we're gonna be skipping lunch. Hello, shopkeep. Bye, shopkeep. And then we're gonna go say hi to Mr. Slendy. Can we call him Mr. Slendy? Are we that type of relationship yet? No, not yet. Okay, fine. The class! That day you listen to your elders and learn valuable lessons. Sometimes after all the monster nonsense and dating gimmicks, you forget that attending class is supposed to be the primary activity at this high school. You gain 2 smarts. You're absent-mindedly walking down the hallway while analyzing the rather suspicious picture of Mr. Slenderman stalking kids. We're all monsters, aren't we? But that's a totally new level of wrong. You yourself have made some pretty questionable decisions that have led you to detention a couple times, plus that one stint in jail, but this is... Oof! You were so distracted by the photograph that you just bumped into Mr. Slenderman himself.
Nez, be careful where you're walking. I find it difficult to not see me, but you on the other hand...
Well, he's not wrong. He's like 3 meters tall. That's really tall for those of you who don't know the metric measurements. At least one of us is graduating from Spooky High this year, while you... Whatever, you're ready to make him sweat under a hot lamp in a small room. But you're in the middle of the hallway, so you settle for narrowing your eyes with suspicion and asking him what he's doing lurking around schoolyards like a creep.
I am shocked by your accusations, Nez. Mind sharing your evidence with me?
You show him the picture, which only unsettles him. You consider explaining that you bought it for a dollar, but he seems uneasy, and the school motto is well known for being snitches get stitches, so you doubt.
It is mine indeed. I am the teacher for Stalking 101, after all.
Oh, right. Yeah, he must be a real master at stalking, but why kids, huh?
Well, although it is my job to teach you all how to properly stalk your future victims, I did not get my PhD in stalking children for nothing.
So, you just wonder, why oh why?
I am actually glad you asked me. I shall explain since it is my specialty. I conducted my complete PhD thesis on the matter of the real purpose of children for monster kind. It took me several years, but after collecting the appropriate amount of children, I was finally able to produce electricity.
Wait, what? Monsters, Inc. type of bullshit? Just what?
You may not know this, but the screams of children are the best quality fuel when properly treated. I am, as a matter of fact, in no real need of teaching at this high school, as I happen to be the owner of a profitable electricity company, or shall I say, a corporation.
Sinful fuck, could he be talking about Monsters Incorporated? Yes, exactly.
But I love my job, and so here I am. I really wouldn't like to have it lost for some misunderstanding.
That would explain a couple things, you guess, but is it truly enough? Do we trust him because he's a teacher and his explanation makes a lot of sense? I mean, look at his suit, he definitely got it with that CEO salary. Or question him claiming you were the one that actually took the picture. He has a pretty swank suit, so we will trust him. You are such a nerd, aren't you?
Well, well, I see you came to your senses, my dear student.
You have no respect for yourself, and so you forgive any criminal. But again, nothing you haven't done for your classmates. But this is a teacher! This is totally different, this is a teacher! At least they were sexy as hell. Then you notice Mr. Slenderman is, as well, and despite being a teacher, sexy as freaking hell, too. Never before you have considered such a lack of face as a sign of hotness. Totally unrelated to the revelation of him being disgustingly rich.
May I have the picture of me you have in your possession, then? I am looking forward to use it for our next class, since I am actually shocked by you having it. You know, humans should not be allowed to see me under those circumstances. It may be bad for my reputation. Unless, of course, it had been taken by a monster.
Well, that would make sense. You bought it from Valerie. You consider if giving it back, but hey, you just got a crush on the man, so you're not letting go of this small piece of image, even if it makes you look like a weirdo.
Yes, I guess if you want to keep it with academical purposes, you might. As long as, of course, you apply yourself to my class as expected. Remember to bring your homework, Nez. I would hate to give you detention.
Is that a threat or a promise? Anyway, Mr. Slenderman leaves you so you could think of what homework you were supposed to hand in. You actually bought it from someone in the toilets and you read it 2 minutes before class. It ended up being a totally enlightening essay on how to properly stalk toddlers without getting shot in the process. You have never been so excited about education as now that you see a real purpose for it, trying to boink your teacher. You gain 2 smarts and 1 creativity. Really? That's where we're going? Fine. Week 2, morning!
Let's go!
Where do we go? Let's go say hi to Shopkeep.
Give me your money.
Hello, Shopkeep. Yeah. Bye, Shopkeep. Week 2, noon.
Let's go!
Now, who do we hang out with? Let's go with Zoe and Liam. You find Liam bending over his burrito with intense concentration. He's obviously taking a food pic for Instagram. He channels the silent energy of the moon. Zoe's right behind him, peeking over his shoulder and giggling. She channels the giggling energy of the moon.
Oh, hey. Liam, this pic is all wrong. Tell the burrito to smile with its eyes and make his cheese look less melty and add a filter. Filter more, filter again.
Why must I constantly be disturbed while taking my refined food pics? No one understands my superior sense of frame.
Maybe because that's my phone you're using?
A fair point. But my phone is charging. What am I supposed to do with this food in the cafeteria at lunchtime? Eat it? I think not!
You purple dork. I'm just saying that if you wanted to reach true levels of Tex-Mex beauty, you should add the sticker of Jimin to your food pic. Nothing says good taste like facing the face of a K-pop superstar next to your high school burrito. Pure egg yolk.
And for a moment, all three of you just admire the gym and sicker. Liam shakes it off and regains his composure. Let's agree to disagree, timeless horror.
Or let's put Jimin in your dumb food pic.
Stop it! Quick, fix this burrito Instagram K-pop emergency. True K-pop fans should know that Jimin's favorite food is enchiladas, and his second favorite food is leaving Liam alone. Or what if we use the Jimin sticker where he's contemplating the existential notions of death, meaningless, and the void? Ah, yes, five head. Ah, you had me at meaningless. I'll allow this nonsense.
Yay, now snap that thing!
I must admit, Jimin adds a quite powerful pathos to this bean and cheese burrito. This appropriation of mainstream culture is quite satisfying. And Zoe's pick goes mega uber super viral, and now the whole world is Jimining their burritos. Geez, the internet is weird, but not as weird as your high school. Jimining your burritos, the new trend. Week 2, evening. Let's say hi to shopkeep.
Hey, stranger.
And then goes her. Week 3, morning. Where do we go to? Let's go to the bathrooms. That day you skip class and just hang out in the bathrooms because you respect no authority. I guess some people just want to watch the world burn. By skipping class and hanging out in the bathrooms, you give zero shits but you gain two boldness. You hear Miranda talking to herself, clearly upset about something. You have not given up your crush on her, just like you have not given up on your classmates, you promiscuous bitch. So you approach her.
Mr. Slenderman has just failed me. Something about me not attending his classes. But that is impossible. I have sent my serfs to represent me to all of them. I should have at least 120% of the attendance of his class. This is outrageous. But not for long. I will make sure to let him know nobody messes with Miranda Vanderbilt.
Whoa, Miranda. We do not kill our teachers at this school. What do we do? Side with Miranda and tell her all about Mr. Slenderman's picture, or side with Mr. Slenderman and inform Miranda that she is supposed to attend classes herself?
Yeah, Miranda. That's kind of the point of this school. Huh? You are on his side? You don't understand, I have so much more important things to do instead of attending such a commoner class.
You explain how you actually consider Mr. Slenderman's class to be somehow interesting and enlightening, but you two have clearly different ideas.
I am royalty. My duties go beyond writing essays or learning the appropriate ways of paying my taxes. That is such a commoner thing. My time must be properly used in majestic things such as brushing my hair with the most marvelous of the fork sand while learning the entire lyrics for Let's Get Down to Business. Can't you see? Those are really useful.
Disgraceful.
But stalking children 101? So disgraceful. I cannot be seen lurking kids. What will my father think of it? I don't even eat them.
Honestly, it does look awful in any resume, but before you can say anything, you two get interrupted.
I think I've already heard enough, Miss Vanderbilt. If that is how you truly feel about my class, then it is only natural that you fail it, isn't it?
Miranda looks at you in despair, clearly begging for help. This is your moment. You ask for permission to talk, which is granted by Mr. Slenderman, only to tell Miranda was actually asking for you to help. She seems shocked, embarrassed, and insulted by this.
Oh, is it so, Miss Miranda?
Yes? Yes, it is. It has come to my conclusion that I am not qualified for your class as most of my serfs and victims are in a different range of age. Luckily, Nez is an expert at stalking toddlers, children, and teenagers under different circumstances and for so many different purposes.
Hey, wait, don't expose us! Damn, bro, is that really how all of your classmates see you? Yes. Maybe that's why you're so unpopular and so many restriction orders have been lifted against you.
Indeed, Mr. Nez has overcome his difficulties in my class in the most unsettling ways. If it is so, I shall allow you to continue attending my class. Just try to the best of your abilities to attend them yourself and not one of your serfs, as you call them.
I can surely try.
I must depart.
And Miranda winks at you as a clear thank you and not as a sign of hitting on you. She would never hit on you, specifically not now that you've kind of been portrayed as a child molester.
I'm positively amazed by your later performance in my class, Nez. You possess a predisposition to scare children. I am looking forward for your final project.
Wow, you're not sure how or why, but Mr. Slenderman seems to really believe in your eminence at creeping children out, yes. You should really start worrying about how others see you, but for now, being such a weirdo ended well for you. You gained 2 charm and 1 smarts. Really? Really? Is that how we're always seen? Kinda weird, champ. Anyway, week 3 noon. Let's go say hi to shopkeep. Ah shit, we activated her dating thing again. Hold up. Shopkeep. Wait up. Hold up. Okay. How do we do this? DIY, fuck it. Oh shit, it worked. No, shopkeep, no. Hold up. Fuck you. Shopkeep, no. We're not dating you today. We're trying to go after Mr. Slenderman. However ambiguously immoral trying to boy your teacher is. Anyway, week 3, evening. Let's go to class. That day, you're the first one in class. You sometimes come early because you enjoy talking to the teacher, Mr. Slenderman. He's a bit bitter, but in a cool way. He treats you like an adult and the two of you discuss life and stuff in a very snarky way. Look at you, excelling at cliched movie tropes. You gain 2 smarts and 1 valuable life insight that'll help you face the difficulties of being young. And wandering around, just as usual, you contemplate your options to prom. When the sexiest of all ghosts appear in front of you. When the sexiest of all ghosts appear in front of you.
Hey, Boo!
Hey, Boo! I've been looking for you all morning!
Could it be a real chance with Sex Solly, the stupid way you call Polly in your mind? Beg for the coven to never read your mind, by the way.
Rumor has it you have something with Mr. Slenderman. I've been trying to hunt down that hottie for, like, all my afterlife. At least since I heard about his, you know, tentacles. But he's too much into that teacher-student policy bullshit.
Just what is happening? Yes, you may or may not consider Mr. Slenderman sexy, as if the hell itself was condemned to hell, but who could have started such a rumor? Polly's clearly waiting for an answer, but your mind is still going all over the tentacles part. Polly's clearly waiting for an answer, but your mind is still going all over the tentacles part.
Cool.
So, say, is it true or not? Because that would be, like, totally cool.
Are we actually into Mr. Slendy? Do we pretend it is true in a totally cool and sassy attitude, even when it could cost him his job, but who cares? You could totally score with Polly. Or do we confess that you have only dreamed of multiple and wicked scenarios, but never truly done anything, since you are as virgin as can be? Hey, wait!
I am a bit let down, but at the same time, I can see that great minds think alike. So many possibilities, so many scenarios, so many tentacles. Rumor says he's even got them in his mouth.
Wait a minute, in his mouth?
Hi, sir.
Dear Kraken, Mr. Slenderman got into conversation at the worst possible time.
Miss Guts, I am only here to remind you of all of your poor afterlife decisions.
Seriously?
But what did I do now?
What about handing me in the final project, which is written bangly in the first 3 pages, only to be continued by other 23 pages of, and I quote, positions you would like to try with me?
Oh yes, my masterpiece! Did you enjoy it?
Your poor use of the language left me speechless.
Because of how good it was?
No. Because of its complete lack of sense.
Aw, Boo!
Poor Polly, she just wanted some banging, and at the end of the day, isn't that the reason why all of us are in this school? No, only you. Yes, only me.
I must emphasize the importance of you rewriting your essay on how to kidnap a kid without the FBI tracking you down and making a complete internet documentary about you, if you still hold any intention of approving my class. And attending prom.
But prom is my thing, it's gonna be the wildest party ever! I already ordered a complete truck of cocaine!
Well, you can do cocaine every day. Question is, can you approve my class every day?
You know, I've been here for like 100 years for that class. Fine, I'll go rewrite it.
Try to include 100% less of the word lick and we should be fine.
Oh no, it's now your turn to get all bossed around.
And you. Your final project was actually breathtaking. I enjoyed it very much. Maybe too much.
Wait, what?
One thing is for sure, Nez. You and I will no longer be student-teacher for much longer.
Oh yes! You totally made it into his heart with your amazing writing skills! If only we knew what we actually wrote. Today you are a dull and self-proclaimed virgin, tomorrow you could be Mr. Nez, King of the Tentacles. You gain 2 smarts for that masterful essay and 1 creativity for creating so wicked fantasies. Really? We never even got to learn what we wrote! Okay then. But anyway, can we take Mr. Slendy to prom? It is finally prom day and you have decided to go by yourself. Because after all these 30 to 60 minutes, you have realized that you're really not into any of your classmates. No, sir.
You're actually into Mr. Slenderman and how not to be after all of that beautiful time you shared. Like that time you accused him of harassing children, or when he almost failed you for incriminating him, or yeah, what a good time you two shared. Sadly, he has this strict policy of not dating students, so you come to prom alone.
Wait, what?
Your other classmates start rumors of your lameness and failure at social life, and they are not wrong. But just when you thought you were going to spend the rest of your night in life alone with 100 cats, Mr. Slenderman himself presents to you.
Mr. Nez, the one and only student who showed real interest for my class and myself. It has come to my attention that you're currently attending prom by yourself, which is both brave and inspiring. Furthermore, you may like to think my proposition twice before answering. Tonight, you stop being my student as you properly graduated from Spooky High, and so would you consider sharing this last dance with me?
We can dance with Mr. Slenderman! And you totally don't need to think twice, as he totally made or got a mod for this to happen. So you don't even finish reading this paragraph and simply continue. And you two spend the rest of your night dancing in a rather awkward way, considering he is way taller than you. But everything becomes simpler with tentacles, doesn't it? You look forward to find out soon. And what happened to you two after Monster Prom? Not really relevant, you will end up believing whatever it is convenient for you anyways. We got to date Mr. Slenderman! Hooray! More creepypasta monsters, please. And those 3 weeks were maybe the most epic and absurd weeks of our lives. After the Monster Prom, we kept on living our lives, falling in love, battling for friendship, and learning who we were and who we could be. And you know what? Like it always does, life happened and it was wonderful. Scott became a world-renowned athlete, but he ended his career to come back to his hometown and take on the job of the athlete he admired the most. Now he's back at the high school again, working as a coach. Zoe's many years of researching obscure trivia for her steamy fanfics finally paid off. She got a job as a consultant at a company who makes fantasy sex toys based on beloved pop culture characters. Now she rakes in the big bucks designing blueprints for stuff like the cock of a Demogorgon or the vagina of the Statue of Liberty. Calculesser went on to Robo University and majored in mecha robotics. He's now 250 feet tall and fights against weird... He's now 250 feet tall and fights against weird giant creatures protecting Tokyo 3. For those 3 weeks, the Monster Prom seemed larger than life and then it was gone just like that. The battle for Monster Prom might have ended then, but there were plenty of battles left in that war called youth. But once again, we were young and afraid, and we were ready to start. And that was the Mr. Slenderman mod by Cami. If you friendos enjoyed that mod, leave your comments down below and like and subscribe so we can grow our channel together. Also, hit that notification bell to always stay up to date with our videos. But until the next episode of Monster Prom, my name is Nez and thanks for watching. See you all next time. Bye, friendos!